Our mini message today will be in Genesis chapter 27, and we're starting this chapter fresh. And this is one of the most famous chapters in the Bible. This is when Isaac tries to bless Esau and Jacob steals the blessing. Now, I remember being a kid and reading this and feeling bad for Isaac. I'm like, why is everybody trying to trick this poor old guy? What did he ever do to anybody? But when you dig in, you see Isaac was being just as deceptive as everybody else. Let's just look at four quick verses. It says, one day when Isaac was old and turning blind, he called for Esau, his older son, and said, my son. Yes, father, Esau replied. I'm an old man now, Isaac said, and I don't know when I may die. Take your bow and a quiver full of arrows and go out into the open country to hunt some wild game for me. Prepare my favorite dish and bring it here for me to eat. Then I will pronounce the blessing that belongs to you, my firstborn son, before I die. So Isaac believes his time has come. Now, in actuality, he's going to live quite a while longer. Kind of the high end is 40 years, but a lot of scholars think it was more in the line of 25 to 30 years that he would live even after this. But maybe he was having a bad day. He had had a recent illness and he thought, this is it. I'm going to be checking out. And so he wanted to give this blessing. Now, the blessing is really important. It was like just bestowing all the good things that the father could upon the son, blessing him, passing on everything that he could to his son. And there's a big problem here with that. The problem being, this was something that was supposed to happen with the entire family. But Isaac calls Esau in alone and tells him this kind of on the sly. Not with the whole family. See, this was supposed to be a big ceremony. This was a big deal. So Isaac is doing this and he's keeping it from his wife and his other son. Now, why would he do that? Well, number one, Isaac has kind of not seen who Esau really is, I think. Esau, we know from the previous chapter, has married a lot of pagan wives that were worshiping other gods. And it had caused nothing but problems in the family. He sold his birthright to his brother for a bowl of soup. So he really didn't care about any of this, it seems. Then on top of even that, God had pronounced from before these two were born who the son of promise would be and who this promise, this blessing, this covenant would go from Abraham to Isaac to Jacob. That Jacob would be the one that would continue the line that would form the nation of Israel. But Isaac just doesn't seem to care about this. So my thoughts as a little boy was, why are they trying to fool this poor old blind guy? But in reality, the poor old blind guy was the one trying to fool everybody too. There are no innocents in this story. You guys have a great day, and we'll see you again soon.